Today we have someone who's actually a really good friend of mine, and I don't know that I'm going to be able to do this intro with a straight face. I'm already going to start laughing because, like that. All right, let's just jump right into it. Hooman, thank you for being on the show.
Thank you for having me.
All right, so Hooman, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourselves for those who don't have the privilege of knowing you the way I do.
You know, it's funny. We've known each other for, I think, 7 or 8 years now, and I've recently learned you stopped having barbecues at your house and parties.
Recently learned, which is crazy, right? Because I actually haven't had a barbecue for multiple years, but
right.
That's just the world we live in. So you...
yeah, so anyway, back to me. I'm a morning show personality in San Francisco. I work at a radio station called Alice at 97.3.
I think personality is a good word.
Thank you. Trying to keep it, you know, professional. And I also shot the first full-length feature film entirely on a cell phone, smartphone. I co-directed it, co-wrote it, co-produced it.
Well, you've actually had your hands in a lot of things over the years. I listen to you on the radio. I see you at every tech event that there is. You have interviewed some of the biggest celebrities and also some of the most prominent entrepreneurs in the world. You have had shows. You're online. You've done some really amazing things just over the time I've known you, and now you're making full-length motion pictures shot on the smartphone. What was the inspiration behind that? And what's it called? Let's start with that.
Well, the movie's called Olive. But before we get into Olive, I want to throw a disclaimer out here.
Okay.
You know, one thing you and I have in common is we throw ourselves into many different situations and scenarios. And, you know, because you live in America and because there's so much opportunity, you don't know what's going to stick. You know, before you wrote your 17 books, you were doing like a bunch of other things. You were advisors at different companies, and yeah, you know, I did my Man on the Street bits. I had my YouTube channel. I tried to do a startup as well, and those things just didn't work. So to bring us to present day, I did shoot the first full-length feature on a cell phone. It's called Olive. It stars two-time Academy-nominated actress Jenna Rollins. It has 5 original songs by Dolly Parton. In 2010, there were 968 films released in theaters. And I had to come up with a groundbreaking angle to make this one rise to the top. The film is about a little girl that transforms the lives of 3 people without speaking one word. It's a heartwarming, family-friendly, charming motion picture.
I mean, just in the description of that, it's making me smile. What was the inspiration behind it? I mean, how did you guys come up with the idea?
In my opinion, the best animated film ever made is a French movie called The Triplets of Belleville.
Oh, yeah.
Did you see it?
Yeah, I have the soundtrack as well.
It is so brilliant. But the one thing that I got from that film was so much can be conveyed without one word being spoken. You know, after seeing that movie 45 times, something clicked in me, and I thought, I want to make a movie where the lead character doesn't speak but conveys everything perfectly. And then the other film that really was a huge inspiration, which everyone's seen, is called Amelie. And once again, you had a character who, even though she spoke, everything was her eyes and her eyebrows and her facial expressions. And so those two films kind of were the catalyst for Olive.
How long did it take you to make it?
So Chris Kelly, former Facebook exec, he is the one who funded it. We shot the film for about $430,000.
That's which, one expensive smartphone.
I know, right? we shot it in 28 days. The pre-production was about 4 months. And, I mean, that's kind of fast for a 90-minute movie. We, you know, this being our first film, we didn't plan for any sick days. We didn't plan for bad weather. And we didn't plan for malfunctions. And even though all 3 of those things happened, we still made it work.
What did production look like for you? How many smartphones did it take? What did the crew look like?
So we had a super small crew. One thing we didn't have in our movie was a script supervisor, which is just like you're begging for disaster if you don't have that. You know, you don't have anybody looking at the script, making sure every word is said just the right way to bring forth the next line. But Pat, my co-director, he was on it. Our crew was small. We maybe had 8 to 10 people.
Wow.
And one great thing about Jenna Rollins is she said, you know, when she signed on, because she knew she was working with 2 first-time directors, she said, this movie for the next 2 weeks, because we had her for 2 weeks, this is my family. and I want to get to know my family. So can you please bring everyone to a banquet room so I can sit down and get to know everyone? She sat with each person, shook everyone's hands, got to know everyone's names. And from her, we learned how to talk to actors, how to work with actors, what was inappropriate to say. It was a really stressful but incredibly growing experience. I became friends with a man named Tom Sebastian, who was the former chief creative officer of William Morris. And he saw the film and he said, you know, you guys have democratized filmmaking. Now let's see if we can democratize distribution.
So what does that look like?
I know, right? Well, it's got to be somewhat digital. You know, when a movie goes into a theater, it's like a firework. It explodes, it's shiny, and then it's gone. And that's it. And this movie is really special. It deserves to have a longer life than that.
Yeah, I actually, you did leak some scenes online.
And I did.
I did find it incredibly charming. And then you also shared Dolly Parton in the studio and the conversation that you had. I don't even know how you've been able to align all these amazing people, not just behind the scenes, but in front of the camera as well. But you're incredibly connected. I think a lot of people want to see you win. You're a guy that has had, you talked about things not sticking earlier, but you've had a lot of success. Everybody knows you in not just San Francisco, but in the tech sector. I'm really just impressed.
Oh, thank you. Well, listen, one thing I admire about you, and I think one thing you and I have in common, is it's easy to sit at home and be lazy and not go out. And one thing that we share in common is we go to most of the things we're invited to. And we'll make an effort to meet people and engage and get to know the people in the room. And I have a very special job in San Francisco, and it affords me the ability to go to a lot of cool events. Look, the only reason I'm in the tech world is because there are so many startups and they're like, can you give us a shout out on the air? I'll do it. I'll figure out a way to do it and I'll help people out. And you do the same thing, by the way. You know, I don't know if you're still a PR maven, but you used to do that and you used to help people out left and right. And ultimately that's what it comes down to. Don't be lazy and go out, meet people and help out when you can. Don't expect anything in return. Because one thing I've learned from doing this film, literally every single person that I guess owed me a favor that I went to turned around and said, I know you helped me, but there's nothing I can do for you. And these are the people in the movie industry, and these are the VCs of Silicon Valley. And they still call, and they still say, hey, can you help me? And you know, you don't want to be a doormat.
That's an important lesson in life. What's the URL for the movie?
Oh, it's olivethemovie.com.
I like that. I like that because that's easy to remember. So
What do you think of the name Olive? O-L-I-V-E.
Well,
do you find it charming? Do you find it cute?
Olive is a name that actually is endearing.
Yeah.
And I think that's because of all of those years of watching Popeye.
Oh, okay. Right.
But it really is. And actually, I think the film itself is equally charming. I think it's an appropriate name.
Right. Thank you.
Well, you're welcome.
So you're about to ask me what's next?
I forgot what I was going to ask you. I'm kidding. But what is next?
Olive is not going to be a one-off.
So Olive, there's Olive Part 2?
There is going to be some other episodes, yeah, or other films.
And like Olive, scary movie? Just keep going?
Well, and Olive is going to change. She's not going to just be a white girl. You know, she might change ethnicities and ages. I think we're going to stick with the whole girl theme. You know what's interesting is you meet so many people when you have a project like this, a project that's new and innovative. And at the beginning, initially, everyone is so hot and they all want to be a part of it. And people will start falling off left and right and you won't know how to stop it. You won't know what to do. And all you can do is literally keep moving forward and pick up more people. Because people are always jumping on your car and jumping off. And hopefully, by the time you hit that finish line, the people that are still on that car will literally be your team for the next one. You know, it's one of the, and you've experienced the same thing. I mean, the amount of people you've hired and see move on and quit, and then, you know, you've had the same crew for 4 years.
Well, I like them. But there is something to be said about relationships. And I really take to heart the point you brought up earlier about how when you needed to lean back on the people who leaned on you before, that they're not there for you. And that's important. It's hard for, I mean, you're a nice guy, and it's hard to really see things in other people that isn't just inherently good. And I have the same sort of outlook. And I can tell you, too, that any time I have leaned on my community for support, there have been people who just aren't there. There's also people that who've always been there, like you. And so I appreciate that. That's why I think we kind of stay in the same car, even when we go in different directions every now and then. We do come back on the same road together, and that's important. You've been an integral part of this community. The tech community relies upon you. I mean, you're part of what we can just call sort of old media. I mean, you're on the radio, but people are very loyal to you and the program. You've been on there for many years. You're now dabbling in movie making. You're now dabbling in content for the smaller screen, which I think is actually a big deal. So just take us out with what your vision is for the future of content and what people need to think about in terms of entrepreneurialism for content creation.
You know, I think Netflix and Amazon are onto something when they're putting in tens or hundreds of million dollars into original content. One thing I see HBO doing better than anyone else is Game of Thrones. And Game of Thrones is such a well-crafted show, but its online component is so brilliant because it's so interactive. You can point on the person's clothing or where they are in the world and see where it is or where you can buy that. And making things that interactive, I really think is the way to go. You know, and if you don't migrate towards the coolest, most cutting edge direction of technology, you will get left in the dust. So HBO, Amazon, Netflix, they're definitely on the right path.
Well, certainly they are. And so, Hooman, you're not only a friend, you're an inspiration.
Thanks for being on the show. Oh, come on, man. Thanks.